Toplo pozdravljeni. Moje ime je Eda Čufer in danes sem tukaj, da bi vam predstavila kratek zgodovinski in konceptualni oris Neue Slowenische Kunsta, umetniškega kolektiva, ki je stalno nastanjen v Ljubljani, Sloveniji. In 1984, in then still existing socialist Yugoslavia, three independent groups merged into a larger collective formation and adopted the name Neue Slowenische Kunst, or NSK. The name was chosen to extend the successful code-playing deployed by one of the constituent groups. The musical group Laibach had adopted the German name for the city of Ljubljana, which in Slovenian equals Laibach in German, where Neue Slowenische Kunst was founded and where it is still based. In the post-World War II historic context, where sovereign European socialist and liberal democratic states constituted their moral and political values on the military defeat of Nazi Germany, Neue Slowenische Kunst functioned as a double code, its meaning and message hidden in contentious contradiction between the denotative meaning of the statement, translated into English, New Slovenian Art, and the medium in which it was expressed, the German language. In the first decade, NSK activities were interwoven with the cultural and geopolitical affairs that would lead to the fall of communism and the dissolution of East European socialist states. Following the fall of the East, which culminated in the destruction of Yugoslavia and subsequent inauguration of independent state of Slovenia in 1991, the NSK collective transformed itself into NSK state in time and started to issue its own NSK passport in 1992. In October 2010, NSK state passport holders and NSK founders met at the first NSK Citizens Congress in Berlin, where a series of debates on the future of the statehood and the prospects of global citizenship took place. For more than 30 years, NSK, and consequently the NSK state, has existed as an indeterminate form and protean discourse. Its meaning and shape mutates and transforms in an ongoing dialogue with, on the one hand, delirious historic events, and on the other hand, the shifting function and definition of art. Allegedly, the art we knew and learned about in school symbolically ended already back in 1913, when Kazimir Maljevic conceived the icon of Black Square, and when Marcel Duchamp made his bicycle wheel. World War I, which started less than a year later, and the October Revolution in 1917, can similarly be thought as the end of classical colonialism, followed by the qualitative leap into an entirely new human adventure. The world, which had been an object of exploration and colonization from the 15th century on, was finally depicted, mapped, and owned. New modes of inverted colonization and exploitation practiced by modern and ultra-modern forms of power, and those are just another name for regulated and institutionalized spectatorship with the goal of molding the living perceptions and actions of masses, become gradually more and more adept of masking themselves into artistic and spectacular forms. In 1936, a kindred spirit wrote, quote, "All efforts to render politics aesthetic culminate in one thing, war. Self-alienation has reached such a degree that it can experience experience its own destruction as an aesthetic pleasure of the first order. End of quote. Art could continue to signify as art only by subverting its definition and practice, from being understood mostly as a depicting and reflecting a positive, phenomenal world. Art in the last century stepped out of fixed and conventionalized semiotic orders and transformed itself into a positive, non-mediated, and unpredictable form of lived world itself, often disguising itself as a political, military, corporate, or other living social form. Following the analysis of the conditions just mentioned, NSK organized itself as a living entity, at first mimicking and later becoming a state, in a state of permanent becoming. In so doing, NSK practice rigorously eclipses the subjectivity of the author with the object of his or her creation, and consequently merges the subjectivities of the author and spectator into an indivisible and circular author-spectator-doer form. By its use of strategic and tactical means of doubling, re-theatralizing and repeating, and its declarative surrender of authorial control over the final form of the so-called artwork, NSK practice attains access to the precarious realms of historic uncertainty, where the actual NSK artwork is ceaselessly formed and performed. Hvala za pozornost.